let me start off by just telling you that myself, eBay, our core ADOS supporters are in support of Donald Trump or the Republicans. Much of their programs and policies have destroyed Black America. We are here demanding a Democratic Party that has sucked up the very life juice out of Black communities. And what you see is that white America refuses to understand that we make this discussion happen. Not anybody that's a Black immigrant, not anybody that's a white conservative. American descendants of slavery have a voice. Understand that fundamentally we come back to the conundrum of calling ourselves African American. The term was built for the progeny of American slavery. That's why it's using a continent and a country in such a specific way to describe a people. See, people, as I said before, that are from Kenya, and that are from Nigeria, and that are from Eritrea, they call themselves by their country with America, if not just their country in some cases. They'll be here and just be Nigerian. In addition, they might even go as specific as to call themselves by their tribe. So what America is trying to say, what everyone is trying to tell us, is that we don't exist, we don't have a right to be specific, but everybody else can in a country that our families built. That is the opposite of possession. They're calling us visitors, transient in our own country. None of it makes sense. We don't have it out today, though. We are here demanding a Democratic Party that has sucked the very life juice out of Black communities to deliver to Black communities what they're owed and then what they should get beyond that. What they're owed is reparations. What they should get beyond that is a Black agenda that makes them American. You cannot get reparation under the guise of color. It is for lineage and specific damage. It is for specific harm, specific damage. We are going to be standing in the shoes of our forefathers. How do you exist in a first world country that developed so much wealth and have so little?